Lord, child, Lord have mercy. Here come the cracker man. He's the one who cracks the whip to keep you in line.
Okay, well, what is, besides the...
And the so-called Jews, I say so-called, not in mockery, Brother Dominic. I'm not playing to any cameras. They are the so-called Jews because we are the true Jews, the true Hebrews, the true and real Israelites. Right, has been stolen by them. We are the true ones that fulfill Bible prophecy and scripture.
Isn't it a fact that you know by throwing out those terms, you're guaranteed press coverage?
I'm not throwing out terms. I'm fighting age-old enemies, and I'm planting seeds in the minds and hearts of the youth and the masses of my people that we will not make the same mistakes again. As they say in the so-called Jewish community, never again, never again.
What happened in your life that gave you your personal experience, your perspective on Jews in your lifetime?
Study, experience, living, studying the teachings of Dr. Yosef ben Yochanan, studying the teachings of Dr. John Henry Clark, studying the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Minister Malcolm X, the Honorable Marcus Mosiah Garvey, and Sir Louis Farrakhan, Dr. Barashango, and Browder, and Akbar, and many others. There are volumes of material, and even studying the book called The Secret Relationship Between Blacks and Jews, a book that thick with nothing but Jew, so-called Jew historians and scholars who explain their role in the black or the African Holocaust.
Do you have a Jewish friend?
No, sir, I do not have a Jewish friend. I am the black Jew. I am the black Hebrew. I am a member of the family of the black Hebrew Israelites. But if you're asking me, do I have a white so-called Jew friend who is not in that line of Semites, so I can't be anti-Semitic? Did you know that there are Semites in Africa? Did you know that there are Semites in Asia? That there are some Semites so black and purple black and beautiful? These are people using a political term, anti-Semitism.
We believe in the truth that is in the Bible, but we don't believe in the lies that the white man has put in the Bible. We believe in the prophets and the scriptures they brought to the people. We believe in the resurrection of the dead, not in the physical resurrection, but in mental resurrection. We believe that the so-called Negroes are most in need of mental resurrection. Therefore, they will be resurrected first. We believe in the resurrection of the dead, but not when you're physically dead. When you stop breathing and your heart stops beating and that man stick you in the ground, that's all she wrote. You are not going anywhere. Your soul isn't going anywhere. Your body isn't going anywhere. Nothing is happening after that. When you're dead, you're done. That's it. You can forget it. Then if that's all of it, what about the resurrection? He says that our people are dead. Negroes are dead. Walking zombies. You're the one that the book is talking about who is dead. Dead to the knowledge of yourself. Dead to the knowledge of your own people. Dead to the knowledge of your own God. Dead to the knowledge of the devil. Why, you don't even know who the devil is. You think the devil is someone down inside the ground that's going to burn you after you're dead. Why, the devil is right here on top of this earth, and he's giving you hell every day, and you're still too dead to see it. We believe in the resurrection of the dead. We believe that the 20 million black people in America in the last days will be taught the truth. The trumpet of truth will sound in your ear as it's being sounded today. The trumpet of truth, and this truth strikes your ear and strikes your heart. It'll open your eyes. It'll open your ears. It'll make you stand up. It'll do the same thing for you that truth did for the dry bones in the valley. Because the picture of dry bones in the valley is talking about you. The picture of Lazarus laying dead 4 days is talking about you. You are Lazarus. You are the dry bones. You are the prodigal son. You are the lost sheep. You are the people about whom the Bible is speaking who will stand up in the last day when the trumpet is sounded. Black people are waking up. Black people are standing up. Black people are rising up, and they're throwing strength. We believe we are the people of God's choice. That's what we believe. We believe we're the chosen people. We don't believe Jews are the chosen people. We don't believe Jews are the ones going to the promised land. We don't think Jews are a part of God. No, Jews are nothing but another part of that as it is written, that God would choose the rejected and despised. And we can find no other person fitting this description in these last days more than the so-called Negroes in America. We believe in the resurrection of the righteous. We believe in the judgment. We believe this first judgment will take place as God revealed right here in America. Right. The judgment will take place in America. The resurrection will take place in America. The judgment will take place in America. The separation will take place in America. And the destruction will take place in America. Doom will take place in America. Doomsday will take place right here. This is the place the Bible is talking about. When the Bible mentions Babylon, it means America. When the Bible mentions Sodom and Gomorrah, that's America. When the Bible mentions Egypt, that's America. This is Rome. This is Babylon. This is that wicked kingdom that God is going to come and set fighting to in the last day. And you're living in that day right now. And I'm glad.